Good morning, guys. Today I am in the Seaside neighborhood of La Jolla, San Diego. It's a beautiful winter day. The sea lions are barking, the waves are crashing. So let's do a little tour and exploration of one of San Diego's best. Welcome to La Jolla. Admittedly, I'm having a little bit of trouble starting this video because I am so relaxed right now here at La Jolla Shores Park. Has plenty of greenery, nice line of palm trees, and the beach right across the park with tons of surfers and just everyone out today in this beautiful weather. San Diego is just so chill. I don't know how I'm gonna get anything done today, but I should get moving. So let's go explore La Jolla, this beautiful, beautiful city. Okay, and here we have La Jolla Shores Beach, which not much to say about it. It's a nice, beautiful beach. It's actually been a little bit destroyed from the storms that just hit California this January, so the sand isn't very pristine right now. But everyone is still out and about. It's a beautiful day. This is what Southern California is all about, in my opinion. Just relaxing and living life to the fullest. I know everyone won't agree with me with that because SoCal does have its issues, but on days like today, who cares?
We got our lifeguard right over here.
And with great weather, like I said before, hopefully the sea lions are barking today. So let's go a little bit south to La Jolla Cove. But before that, they have a Phil's Coffee in San Diego, which is my favorite coffee shop in Los Angeles, but it's probably not the most popular one down here. Some other more popular coffee shops here in San Diego slash La Jolla are Bird Rock Coffee Roasters here in La Jolla and some other locations in San Diego. Very popular chain, and I am loving this honey bee iced latte, which is oat milk latte with honey and cinnamon. Another popular chain here in La Jolla and San Diego is
Better Buzz Coffee. All of their drinks are great, but they're well known for having a secret menu item called the best drink ever. I've actually never tried it, but if you do, let me know how it is.
Oh, and there's also Dunkin'. San Diego has it all.
On the topic of things to drink and eat, my friends came to visit and we went to my new favorite brunch spot in San Diego, Cody's La Jolla. Aside from the total elegant beach vibe this place gives off and the pretty great food, it overlooks the Pacific, so it is a total vacation vibe. Love it.
Okay, so I am at Wind and Sea San Diego, not Wind and Sea, literally Wind and Sea. I'm gonna start walking over to La Jolla Cove. Look at this little hut I found like right away. Now this is really cool. Right near the parking lot of Wind and Sea Beach. I could stay here all day too. Okay, now I'm walking through Marine Street Beach. I went through the candy cane forests and the swirly twirly gumdrops to get here. And hopefully going back, the tide doesn't come up too much because then I'll be trapped. But here we are at Whispering Sands Beach in La Jolla, and I'm just about to get to the La Jolla tide pools. First, I gotta cross this river. There's the culprit. This is where Pennywise, the clown from It, lives. I should have brought my little yellow boat. And we made it to the La Jolla tide pools. The tide pools are pretty rugged. You gotta watch where you walk because it's pretty slippery and you don't wanna come when the tide's too high. And right down below here, we have Wipeout Beach, which makes sense because the waves here are no joke. So this is without a doubt one of the nicest walks you can do along the coast in Southern California. Ooh, and we're approaching Children's Pool. So the access is closed for whatever reason. It's so pretty. I've done it before. Maybe I actually have some past footage. I think I was wrong actually when I said the sea lions are out barking today. I do not see one sea lion. They are hiding after all these storms we've had.
Move along, sir. Move along.
Well, this park right here is called Ellen Browning Scripps Park.
And it has a beautiful backdrop, of course, of the ocean.
People just hanging out, kicking the ball around, having picnics. I'm just gonna say it, that this area in San Diego, especially on a sunny day, is one of the best vibes you can get in all of Southern California. And of course, the vendors take advantage of that. So if you want some food, beach towels, beach hats, beach dresses, sunglasses, you can find them all in this area.
Ooh, and I hear the sea lions barking.
And look at that, we have found the sea lions. You don't want to approach them though, because they might bite you or chase you. Okay, so I've reached my destination, La Jolla Cove, and this is one of the most popular hotspots in all of San Diego because it's really charming. Oh, and the sea lions are out to say hello. As you can see, people here are obsessed with the sea lions and color coordination, apparently. And we got some nice caves here in La Jolla Cove as well. It's like they filmed a Little Mermaid over here. So usually on a nice warm sunny day, this beach is packed and it's a really nice place to go snorkeling if you're into that as well, because there's a lot of sea life around the cove. Okay, as I was saying that, I almost just walked into a sea lion and now it just barked at me. Okay, and we are approaching golden hour tonight, which means that I gotta come back another day to finish out this video and exploring La Jolla, San Diego's best seaside neighborhood. But for now, enjoy the sunset.
Also, since I have a moment on this little break, if you haven't already, hit that like button and subscribe if you haven't. It really helps me out and I really appreciate it.
Okay, and I am back to explore more of La Jolla. And today I left the coves and the cave for Torrey Pines State Natural Reserve, a 2,000 acre park. And this place is pretty much a California dream. Let me show you why. After I get out of this thing. Ooh. This is one of the largest stretches of land on the California coast, has about 8 hiking trails, and it's also a perfect place to go paragliding. Definitely on my bucket list, honestly, but not today.
Could not be more tempted to do that right now, but I need a film.
Anyway, as I was saying, one of the most popular little hikes in this area is actually a walk down to the beach, and not just any beach, Black's Beach. Okay, and we're on the paved trail, and there's actually not many people doing this today. This is usually very crowded, but it is 58 degrees in the winter time, so Californians are a little scared of that weather. That's okay, that just means I have this whole little hike to myself. I forgot how rugged it is. Also, I wonder, since it's kind of cold, if there will be no naked people walking around, which maybe is a good thing, because I don't want to get them on camera. So this is not the only way to get down to Black's Beach. There are a few other ways. I actually took the Ho Chi Minh Trail about last week or so to get down to Black's Beach, which was actually a little more risky and dangerous than I expected. You can check out my full adventure in my Hidden Gems of San Diego video. I'll link it in the description below. But for now, we're on an easier route. And I'm also wondering, since it's a little chilly out, if there will be no naked people at the beach. Which might be for the best, because I'm filming and don't want to invade their privacy. Alright, so Black's Beach right now is actually pretty empty. There is no one around, probably because of the storms that really mess up with the beaches. They're kind of a mess right now, and it's a cooler day, and it's also not a weekend. But on that note, when I say that it's a nude beach, don't get the wrong idea of that, because it's not like a creepy kind of nude beach. It's more of a freeing scene where people really just come here to relax and not do anything like out of the ordinary or creepy. It's just a total vibe. So keep that in mind. I did mention before that you can also get down here via the Ho Chi Minh Trail upon some other trails, but I took that one in my Hidden Gems of San Diego video. And speaking of hidden gems, there was two others in La Jolla that I discovered. So be sure to check out that video, including a secret swing. And now I think I'm gonna go find another hidden gem on our way up to the mountain for sunset. Okay, the hike up isn't as fun, but we got this. Okay, here is one of the troll bridges. They say if you honk when you're going under it, it will awake the trolls. Trolls are out! Okay, so now we're gonna pass by the Munchkin House here in La Jolla, which is only about a mile away from troll bridges. And we got the Munchkin House. Okay, there's really nowhere to stop, but as you just saw, that was the Munchkin House. It has been rumored that the actors that were the Munchkins in The Wizard of Oz lived in the Munchkin House. I believe it is just fiction and not actually true, but still, pretty cool little hidden gem here in La Jolla. Okay, and as always with my videos, I try to end them with a nice sunset in a nice location. And here at a mountaintop in La Jolla, this place is perfect. It's called Mount Soledad National Veterans Memorial, and it's considered one of the most unique veterans memorials in the country. It is the only memorial that honors veterans living or deceased from the Revolutionary War to present day, with a picture of the veteran here at the memorial. And the best part, it is a great place for San Diego views. It has 360-degree views of San Diego all the way to Mexico. Straight ahead, we have Mexico all the way down to Tijuana, Ensenada. Pretty cool, it's a different country over there. So let's get that drone up, and as always, if you learned something today and enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe for more Southern California content. Appreciate you watching, I'll see you next time. The sunsets at Mount Soledad are just absolutely magical.